Hello, my name is James Wheeler, and I'm one of the co-founders of Fortaloo. It's been a while since we posted on our social media or our blog. We've been busy over the winter building out new features, working on the app. But I thought I'd do a quick post today. It's my first time doing a video post, actually being in front of the camera as opposed to being behind the camera, just being in a landscape shot is what I did a lot of shooting in the summer. The reason I'm doing this post is it is springtime again here in Vancouver, and typically I do a lot more photography and posting to social media in the summer because that's when I do a lot of traveling, and I do a lot of travel photography. So tomorrow, actually, I'm going to be heading out on a trip to China, and I'm going to be there for 3 weeks, and I just thought that I would let you guys know what I'm going to be doing. So I'm planning on making some big changes to my workflow. Up until now, I've been traveling with a Micro Four Thirds camera and a full frame camera with all the lenses. And typically what I do is I go out, and if I'm walking around through the day, I use a Micro Four Thirds. And if I'm going out and doing like a morning or evening shoot, sunrise, sunset, or if I'm doing a night shoot, I'll use a full frame camera. And that works out well because they, you know, the Micro Four Thirds is lighter for around the day, but the larger sensor has always been nice, is nice for when there's low light. But this time I'm going to change it up a bit. I'm only going to bring my Micro Four Thirds cameras and lenses with me. The main reason being they're heavy, right? Like if I look at, this is what my full frame wide angle lens looks like, and this is what my Micro Four Thirds wide angle lens looks like. And it adds up. Once you get a number of different lenses, you know what I mean? You can see that the Micro Four Thirds ones are significantly smaller, right? So, and especially since I always bring both of them, it really lightens up the load just for traveling when I'm going around. The reason I'm going to do that this time is because I just picked up the Panasonic G9. And I was shooting with a GH4 before, which I really like, and I'm actually shooting this video with a GH4. I am going to bring it with me as well, so I kind of have a backup camera. But I really just, you know, the photo quality of the G9 is really good. I can also get 60 megapixel photos with this, with a sensor shift. I've only had it for about a month, so not, you know, 100% sure. I haven't tried everything with it yet, but so far I've been really happy with the quality. And I think it rivals everything I got from the full frame. The only thing that I think I won't be able to do with this that I could do with the full frame is long exposure night shots, right? That's something that you really need the bigger sensor for. But because I'm going to China, in China, it's very difficult to get away from the cities where there's no light pollution. So I wouldn't really be doing any night shots anyways or any Big Dipper shots. So I'm not too concerned about that. So I'm all going to bring the Micro Four Thirds. The other change I'm going to make is normally what I do is when I'm out traveling, I'll take a lot of photos. But I normally don't process them on the road or even go through them on the road. I find I don't have time. And it's just, you know, putting them into Lightroom, loading them up every night is a bit of a pain. What I'm going to be trying this time, though, is I'm going to be using Photoshop CC. So typically I wait till I get home, put them all on my big desktop using Photoshop CC Classic. I guess it's Lightroom CC Classic, I guess it's called right now. What I'm going to try this time is while I'm on the road, I'm going to actually use Lightroom CC. I've played around with it. It has a lot of features, not all the features that that you can get in Classic, but I think it's going to be enough for me to do some pics, do some edits, and then while I'm on the road, I want to post them with Fortaloo, right? So the idea is that I've got these Wi-Fi enabled cameras. I should be able to easily, you know, go out, take a shoot, come back, connect the camera up to my computer, pick some of the good ones, edit them with CC, and then post them to all my social media with Fortaloo, and go through that process pretty quickly. So that's the plan. Pretty big change in my workflow, but I'm going to try it out on this trip. So you'll be seeing, I think, a lot more photos coming up on the stream if you're following me on the social media. And when I get back, I'll write another blog post about how I found it, right? What, you know, what worked well, what didn't go well, and, you know, how I'm going to change it, right? Because another thing that I'm going to need to decide when I get back is right now I've got three cameras because I purchased the G9. I don't need three cameras. I would never ever take more than two anywhere. So I need to decide whether I sell my GH4 or whether I sell my full frame with the lenses when I get back. And this trip is really going to be a test for that. If I don't miss the full frame at all, I may decide to sell that and just stick with two Micro Four Thirds cameras for when I do my travel photography. Anyways, hopefully you enjoyed this video. Follow along on the social media. Just keep an eye out for my posts next week. So appreciate the any likes you can give us, and expect a lot more coming out of the Fotolou posts over the next, you know, the next couple months. Because it is, again, it's summer now, probably between now and October, I'll be posting a lot more because I'll be out shooting a lot more. Anyways, thanks a lot. Hope you enjoyed this.